Greetings to the new episode of Art Beats with Studio T. I'm your host Gilani, bringing you everything about the art world here in Oman. Where are we today? We're at Oman's Affordable Art Show. What is it all about? And who's participating? Well, let's ask artist extraordinaire, acclaimed artist and curator, Radhika Hamlai, and the organizer of this show. Radhika, welcome to the episode.
Thank you very much for being a part of our show.
So, it seems like a really interesting lineup, and I've seen a lot of buzz inside and some really creative work. Shall we go have a look?
For sure.
Wow, I love this space, and I've always been so fascinated by your art. We'll get to your art in a bit, but I want to understand the concept behind this show. How did you come about it, and what was your motive?
I think, you know, what I wanted to do is I wanted to create like a cultural hub for all the artists locally and people who are living in the country, people who are coming from outside to be communicating with each other. So
wow.
This was something I had started off, that a communication from the artist to the artist and giving back to the community.
And I believe, Radhika, that you started it something small and it was experimental. Tell us about that journey.
So at, you know, Bait al Baranda, I had a friend, Malik Al Hinai, who used to run the space.
Yeah.
And we just had 9 artists. And I started off with the space, very, very small, to see how we communicate with each other. And I think that took us to a different level altogether.
Wow.
And that encouraged me to start something like this, which is a yearly thing. Every year in December,
So now this
space.
Is the third year.
This is the third year.
Just a quick word. We want to talk about your art pieces. Okay, walk us about how you would explain this and your concept.
Okay, so my, you know, works are very playful.
Yeah.
Because I think as a human being, we should always have a child within us.
And so, I think the genre is called naive art.
Exactly. I don't know if that's what it's called, but yes, I just play with my art.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's like the king and the queen. That's what I work with. And if you can see, there's a crown and there's a girl. So there's the boy and a girl, and there's a communication and the relationship. Me as a human being with them, and them as a human being with each other. It's basically a form of communication is what I think I put up in my artwork.
Okay, so now we're going to go off and talk to your other artists.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for putting this show together.
Thank you.
And any message for people who want to participate next year?
We open up the entries for September next year. Do follow us on Oman's Affordable Art on Instagram, and you'll hear more about it.
There's so much to see here at the Affordable Art Fair, and so many artists to meet. We will not be able to speak to everyone, but we'll speak to a few. And one of them is my favorite, Tahira Fida. So tell our viewers, what do you have over here?
So here I have what I call it marble glass.
Marble glass?
Yeah, and I don't think anybody is doing it in Oman.
Oh, wow. So it's really interesting. There's glass with some marble elements onto it.
It's marbling technique.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
oh,
it's
wow.
Like technique of coloring.
Oh, wow. I love that. So there's so many pieces. And then you've got some pieces here. Tell us a little bit about this.
This is from Islamic art.
Okay.
Actually, I like to give the effect that it is made of ceramic, but they are not made of ceramic.
They're not made of
ceramic?
Oh my God!
Yeah, they are done on wood.
You're kidding.
And this is one of the techniques that I am famous with. But Tahira. I make my art looks like ceramic pieces, Islamic pieces, because I'm fascinated with Islamic art.
And it looks antique. It looks like it was found in one of the ancient palace walls.
Yeah.
It's really interesting.
Yeah, because I studied Islamic art.
Yeah, yeah.
I did my master's in it. So I went deep into it.
Wow, wow.
And then I came up with my own style.
Thank you for taking time to talk to us.
Thank you so much.
Amongst all these artists, we also have somebody here from Colombia, one of my favorite artists, and I have several of her pieces hanging in my house. Rebecca, how are you doing?
How are you? So nice to see you.
It's lovely to see you, Rebecca. And what a kaleidoscope of colors, an explosion of colors in your stall.
Thank you very much. Welcome to my little world.
It is a very fascinating world. So what I want to ask you is, what is your start of your inspiration? What inspires you?
Well, my art at this moment, I have different series and I keep changing my styles, but I try to always keep at something cheerful, something happy. I inspire in Oman, but I also keep my background, my colors.
And I think it's that vibrant colors that I'm so fascinated and drawn to your art. And the fact that you said you want to keep it cheerful.
That's right.
I think it really exudes that personality of yours through the art pieces that we see.
Well, that's the idea, to create a piece that brings something special to a room.
And how do you stay cheerful in this world today of so much negativity?
Oh gosh, I think what helps me is art.
What helps you is art?
Of course. If I don't have art, then I can get very sad or depressed or focus in the bad things. But art is the best therapy, right?
Yeah.
You just relax and you just forget about everything. And we have the therapy in our hands.
We have the therapy in our hands. One of the things that you do very well is you do this art merchandise. Tell us a little bit about it. Show us, viewers, a little bit about what you do.
Yes, well, I created like every original piece. I tried to create it into small pieces, into a home decor collection.
Home decor.
Okay, so I focus like in things like people can take home, like coasters.
Wow, so so these are these prints or the...
These are small reproductions of
reproductions.
My original art.
Originals, okay.
And they are all coated with resin and I made by myself
in
my studio.
So they're handmade. So it's sent it to a production company. Make them yourself.
I made myself, I applied the resin, I do all the process.
That's wonderful. Well, best of luck on the show.
My friend is so much. I love to see you. Take care.
Take care. Okay. Bye-bye. So let's meet an artist all the way here from Glasgow. Stefan. Hello, Stefan. Welcome to Art Beats.
Thank you.
And tell us a little bit about your art aesthetic and about your stall here.
Well, I've tried to show a variety of the work that I do. I mean, I do some sculpture and painting. But in the painting, there's differences because there's landscape painting. And these are all places that I've been to.
Wow.
Coorum Beach, Gobra, The Wave, Albistan. These sort of local places to me.
Are you based in Oman?
Yes. I'm based in Coorum.
Okay. I love these sculpture pieces that you have.
Well, they're basically the clay ones you see, they're fired. And then I make casts of them in paper.
Ah.
Originally, I used to throw the clay away when I was a poor artist. I couldn't afford more clay. But now I'm not so poor, so I can keep them.
That's great to hear.
These are when I'm out and about, when I'm traveling in Scotland or in Barcelona, in Spain, these sort of places. I do lots of little sketches. Just on site. They normally take about 20, 25 minutes or so, sometimes either a bit longer, because I was managed to spend time in the museum.
Wow.
Museums and stuff.
And I love this.
These are my most recent things. A lot of these involve some of my students and some people I know. Things like this. This is during COVID, where I was just staring outdoors.
And
some of these, I've painted images of my students or friends, that sort of thing. So they're a mixture of memories that I have. So I mix the memories and put them onto the painting.
Wow, that's wonderful. So what inspires you?
I just think the act of creating something. I just love
working. So the more you create, the more it gives you the inspiration.
Yeah, the more I'm
inspired, yes. I finally found him, Mr. Kostas. Here from Greece.
From Greece, Yunnan.
Oh, great. Welcome to Art Beats.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
Tell us a little bit about your art pieces. How do you come up with these figures?
It's just pure inspiration about Oman. Since I came here for first time for holiday, I always wanted to do something for Oman. And inspiration came like a river, like a floating river. It wasn't hard for me to start creating the figures, the Omani figures, and then went to combine the Omani elements with the European elements.
So
I feel home here and I feel home there.
Yes.
So it's like having two hearts beating into different places.
Absolutely.
So this helps me express my love and gratitude for Oman.
Great. And I believe you do workshops as well?
Yes.
So let's meet the busiest artist who's in every exhibition. It's you again.
It's me again. Good to see you.
But for our viewers, introduce yourself.
My name is Julia Jean Davis. My art business is Julia Jean Collages. I'm a collage artist.
She does these amazing collages. So what do you have here to show us?
I have all kinds of things. I have hand-cut designs, old school. People even say to me, People still do that. Yes, people still do that. But then I also have a fusion digital analog version, such as my Good at Making Small Talk. This was a digital photograph of my own that I hand collaged onto. And I also have some digital prints.
And you have these digital prints. So there's a lot to see from your store.
Yes.
And I wish you all the best.
Thank you so much.
And I'm sure if I go to the next exhibition tomorrow, you'll be there.
Yeah, I will. Wherever you go, I'll be there. Thanks so much.
So let's meet the artist who's all the way here from cold Minnesota in the US to very warm Oman. Denise Sabine. Denise, welcome to Art Beats.
Thank you.
And what a lovely collection of your artworks here. Tell us a little bit about this.
Well, this is, it's a kind of a grouping of a lot of different types of art. So we have, this is all oil on paper.
Oil on paper, okay.
We have photography by my husband back in here. Here's photography
okay.
and photography.
Wonderful.
And then I have, largely it's watercolor.
Yes.
But some mixed media always seems to find its way into my work.
Okay, and so you've painted a lot of nature.
Mm-hmm. I like landscapes.
Landscapes, mm-hmm. and so that is your go-to.
That's my primary, I would say.
Okay, great. And what about these?
So with these, you can see there's going to be, of course, something that is a little different than that. But again, this is an oil painting, and I have kind of three motifs I like to go. I like New Mexico. That would be from New Mexico. I like Spain, and I like Oman. So these are then mostly Oman. This would be like Salala, and we've got Misfat, and we've got Yitzhi Beach and the Saal Steps.
And so what is your creative process?
Well, you can see, like, it does depend a little bit on if it's going to be something like strictly landscape, right? And then that's going to be different than a piece like these, where I start with a very abstract foundation, and then I find something in it. So that's
so
what
it sort of develops.
Yes, it does.
And develops, mm-hmm. and develops. Well, it's absolutely a great burst of color, and it sort of intrigues. So really fascinating, and best of luck with the show.
Oh, thanks so much, Gilani.
Okay, so let's meet an Omani talent with a great eye for a creative aesthetic. Mr. Muhammad Al-Atta, and your stage name is?
Maimoun Art.
Maimoun Art.
So for me, art is a form of expression and a place where I can be fully free.
So let's look at these pieces. What are they all about? They're sort of representation of you, aren't they?
Yeah, each one has like a certain phase, life phase, or certain emotions that I had. Like for example, this one has been drawn during the pandemic. It represents that sometimes we look for homes in others, but we actually carry so many homes within ourselves.
Yeah, yeah.
So here's like some time, instead of looking forward a home, you should build and find a home within yourself.
And let's talk about these pieces here.
Okay, I'm doing prints here because most of my works are digital. This one is actually an acrylic piece that I took a snap off and made a print out of it.
Wow, okay, great. So these are fridge magnets and place mats?
These are stickers, prints, and canvases.
At the Affordable Art Show in Oman. What a great collection of creative people all together. Will we see you here next year? I hope so. From me, your host Gilani, and the Art Beats team, goodbye for now.